Don't let anyone try to dictate what your fitness goal should be. It's okay to have different goals for different muscles. The idea of conforming to the crowd, following what's popular in YouTube or Instagram fitness, is a complete waste of time and absolutely destructive to your mental and physical health, in the sense that you will not truly be giving it your all, and lack of motivation will be present most of the time. You're basically forcing yourself like a slave. This is not sacrifice. It's not about discipline. It's about groupthink, being a goddamn sheep, which is so prevalent nowadays. And honestly, it creates an environment that's very judgmental and one-dimensional. And the way that I see it, that's not what the fitness community should be. We need to be as unbiased as we possibly can, giving opportunities to different sports, recognizing that you can do what you want. And that's one of the things I've always respected about gym bros. Many people make fun of them because they just want chest and arms. And you can argue that their training is subpar or that they may not look the best. But you know what? That is their freaking goal. They want abs. They want the beach muscles. It is what it is. Not telling you to train like that. But don't be pressured into doing something that you give zero fucks about. Because let me tell you this. If you don't care about it, chances are other people don't care about it too. Not for themselves though, but in reference to you. What happens when popular lifters get injured, chasing a goal that they never cared about? Oh, a few months later, no one's talking about them anymore. In other words, you're just a temporary thing to give them pleasure in that moment. So if you know this, if you know that people are gonna fucking turn on you in a second, why are you letting them dictate what your training should be like? Why don't you grab your balls and say, fuck this shit. I'm gonna train how I wanna train. I'm gonna build the muscles that I wanna build. And this is where things like specialization comes into play. And I can give you two examples in the sport of powerlifting. You might be a guy who competes in push-pull meets. You don't care about the barbell back squat. Never did, right? Or you could be the guy who does bench-only meets. Some people look down upon, especially if you're not injured in the lower body. But what if it just never crossed your mind of getting a massive squat and deadlift? What if that was never your objective? What if when you first started training, your only objective was to be buff? And then somewhere along the lines, you realize that, yeah, in order to maximize my buffness, I got to get this big bench. And you know what? I like benching heavy. There's a bro element to it, and it's fun. And it really tests the upper body strength in a way that I like. If you have that mindset, then that's perfectly cool. And then maybe do a little bit of leg training, get them balanced from a proportion standpoint, so you got those nice aesthetic looks. And that's it. You're happy, right? You don't care about strength training for that. So what I'm saying is you could specialize while having different performance elements for different muscles. Could even be doing calisthenics only for your upper body, but weights exclusively for your lower body. You don't want to be a calisthenics purist. You want to do heavy squats and deadlifts, not just relying on pistol squats and stuff like that. So once you get out of narrow-minded thinking, everything expands. How do you think I came up with the naturally enhanced philosophy? It was not by conforming to what everyone else was talking about back then, which is great. You know, you want to look aesthetic. And there's different fluffy physiques, like the strongman look. Like, that's pretty much all guys were saying. You can be super aesthetic, look like a bodybuilder, or a strongman, powerlifter type look. But no one was discussing the yoke, the neck, the traps, the upper back, shoulders, forearms, the glutes, all the outer extremities of the body. And the strength training was specifically tailored for those areas. Not to compete in some sport that I don't care about. And this goes for you as well. You can specialize in, say, the overhead press. Maybe you want a massive overhead press, over 225, one rep max, but you don't care about having a huge bench. Or what if you don't care about the weighted pull up? You don't want a big one rep max for that. You really don't care. You just do body weight and then your workout, rows take a priority. What is the issue with that? What's the issue in doing an exercise that has, say, better leverages for your build, but it's not part of a competition, like doing a behind the back deadlift or a high handle trap bar deadlift? What is the problem? What's the problem of doing one rep maxes on some lifts, but not on others? So you'll only max out on a squat, but you won't do it on deadlift. What the fuck is the problem? I'll tell you, there is no problem. Guys make it seem that you're a bad person for not wanting to conform. They make it seem like you're less than a real lifter. I've even heard the argument that if you don't do certain things, you're not a lifter. That automatically disqualifies you as that. This is not about joining people together. It only divides. When you create division in any type of world, that's when conflict arises. We've seen it time and time again. So I'm not gonna go political on your ass, but you know what I'm saying, right? If we approach everything from a place of respect, while of course still holding people accountable, that's when everything becomes positive. That's when you're not ashamed to post what you wanna post and talk freely about your ideas. You're not walking on eggshells, which is what I see many times, especially people who aren't even making a living in the fitness world. They just have an Instagram, they like to post their stuff, but they're still conforming. Why? You can be the jack of all trades, master of none. You can be a specialist as well. What do you want? Ask yourself, what were the initial motivations for training? And did you stray off that path because of someone else's influence? And do you have to force yourself to do those things? And is that reward worth it? Are you really gonna care about it, or are you gonna hit it and then just back off because it was never really on your radar? Sometimes you chase something for so long only to realize that you gave zero fucks about it. And that's a damn shame, especially when people get injured along the way, or they grow as a person, they grow out of these phases, but now they're stuck in a certain world. There's an identity about them. And that's the hard part, getting out of it, because now you've established yourself to a certain extent, right? So what I'm saying is you can escape all that nonsense by being true to yourself. Following your heart, in other words. Could you see yourself doing this activity in 10, 20 years from now? Is this sustainable long-term? Really think about your goals. And I'll say one final thing regarding that. During this quarantine, I saw what the true colors of many lifters were, because everybody was making videos on home training. Hey, you can get buff with bands, you can get buff with calisthenics. I'm gonna say the majority of people did not train, nor did they actually go down that path, even though it was a very viable solution. Why? Because they didn't care about calisthenics. Who am I to force my love for it on you? I can talk about all the benefits. I can give you the information, but at the end of the day, it's your decision to do it. Some people are like, Alex, I'd rather not train. I don't care about this. And no one really cared about that. Why? Because there were other things that were more important and it was more relatable in a sense. So in this way, the groupthink was beneficial because people realized what was actually important and what wasn't. Now I'm gonna extend this to weight training. The gyms are opening up again. You have a choice. How are you gonna train? Are you gonna just do what's popular? Are you gonna try to copy the trends of some fake natty asshole who doesn't care about you? Or are you gonna be like, you know what, Alex? I wanna be aesthetic. I wanna be strong in very specific areas. Some things I just don't care about. Or you know what, I wanna be good at everything. I wanna be the best possible version of me. What is your path? Only you know the answer. All I could do is give you informative videos. And then from there on, it's all you. And that's all I'm trying to say in this video. You do you, screw everybody else. No matter what the consequences are, because you know what's correct. Follow what's in here. Listen to your own self for once. And you'll be so much happier in the long run. I can absolutely promise you that. And your gains are gonna blow up. Even if your routine is not the greatest of all time, because you're committed. You're taking all the right steps to excel at whatever that goal is. Maybe not fun for someone else, but for you, that's what drives you. That's what it's all about. Drive. So with that said, I'm done talking. It's perfectly fine to have different goals for different muscles. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give me your stories in the comment section. Can you relate to what I'm talking about? Let's hear it, and I'll see you next time.